Okay, so we're going to expand the quantity 1 half x plus 1 third y all raised to the fourth power. The first thing we'll do is we'll come way over here and we'll look at Pascal's triangle. So let's write the triangle down. You just write a 1 down, then you put 1s on the sides. 1 plus 1 is 2, you put 1s on the sides. 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 1 is 3, put 1s on the sides. 4, 6, 4, 1s on the sides. Now the reason we stopped here is because this is row 0. This is the first row, second row, third row, fourth row. We stop at the fourth row because this number is a 4. If this were a 5, we would keep going. If this were a 10, well, I wouldn't do it, but we would go all the way down to 10. And here's how you work it out. We'll start by writing the first coefficient, so 1. Right, these are the coefficients right here. So 1, and then we'll write the first term, so 1 half x, and we always start with this number here. So this is a 4, so you put a 4. Then you write the next one, 1 third y, and we write a 0. Plus 4, 1 half x. Now we go down one, so 4 minus 1 is 3, 1 third y, and then you add 1 here, 0 plus 1 is 1. Plus the next coefficient is 6, and then 1 half x squared, and then 1 third y squared. It's really easy to mess up in this next step, and again you'll notice the pattern, 4, 3, 2, 0, 1, 2. Now they're both 2, so it's easy to get mixed up. So 4, 1 half x, and this one is going down, so we go from 2 to 1, 1 third y cubed. And the last one is plus 1, 1 half x to the 0, and then 1 third y to the fourth. Wow, that's really small. Okay, so let's write it up. Let's clean this up. Now, it's usually better just to clean this all up in one step. So the first term, it's 1 half, and it's being raised to the fourth power. So 2 to the fourth is 16, so 1 over 16 x to the fourth, and that's 1. Anything to the 0 power is 1. Plus, here we're going to get a 4. We're going to get a 1 eighth, and we're going to get a 1 third, so that's 1 half. 1 half times 1 sixth, so 1 sixth x cubed y. Over here we have a 6, 1 fourth, 1 ninth, so that's 3 halves times 1 ninth, 1 sixth. So plus 1 sixth x squared y squared. Here we have 4 times 1 half times 1 ninth, times 1 27th. Ooh, easy to mess up there. So this will be 2 over 27. Yeah, I don't sound very confident. 2 over 27 x y cubed. And the last one finally is plus, well, 1 third to the fourth power is 9 times 9, so 1 over 81. Y to the fourth. So you just have to be really, really careful with problems like this. Just take your time with it, and there is the final answer.